Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? You all are excellent. Yes. So today we will continue our previous lesson, that remaining part of the lesson from Moment, The Happy Prince, written by Oscar Wilde. So remaining part that today we will conclude our explanation of that. Page number 32, we were there. Okay, I will read one paragraph for you, that which we have explained last time. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbour. He sat on the mast of a large vessel. What is meant by vessel? Vessel means ship. Okay, here, vessel means ship. Large vessel, and watched the sailors. Sailors, those who work, the people, those who work on ships, called the sailors. Watch the sailors working. I am going to Egypt, cried the swallow. But nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. I have come to bid you goodbye, he cried. He said, I have come here to say you goodbye. I am going to Egypt. Okay. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. Okay, after few days the snow starts, and everywhere the silver like whitish, you know, the silver color we can see because of that snow fall. In Egypt the sun is warm on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazy about them. In the square below, in the area, what is meant by square? The open area in a town. In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. Okay, those who sells the matchbox, that is a match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they are completely spoiled. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money, and she is crying. She has no shoes or stockings. Whatever shoes and stockings, socks, they, it is usually that they always wear stockings because very cold region. And her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. Take out my other eye, sapphire, and give to her. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow. He agreed now. Okay, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then if I will take out your eye. So you will be completely blind then. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Do as I commanded you. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. You know, flew away. Darted down is a, I think so, flew away. Darted down is a flew away. Okay. From one place to the that place where he commanded him it. Swallow, sir. He plucked the other prince of the eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. Slipped means slowly, kept, dropped down. That slipped here, sir. See, dropped very carefully. Slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. What a lovely bit of glass, she said, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said, so I will stay with you always. Okay. No, little swallow, said the poor prince, you must go away to Egypt. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow. And he slept at the prince's feet. You know, previously, he was, the bird was, swallow was ready. He was telling that, let me go. But he was not allowing. Now, he allowed it, bird, to go. Now, bird is not going because the prince is blind. He cannot see any more. All the
the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him story what he had seen in strange lands.
Dear little swallow, said the prince,
you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no misery so great as this misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there as now prince cannot feel. So you fly over everywhere and tell me where is misery in my city. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses. Those who are very rich, they are very happy, they are doing parties and all at home. But the misery people, the poor condition, the poor people's condition, their houses, while the beggars were sitting at the gates, he flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children. Starving, those are very hunger, has not eaten from many days. You know, that is starving children looking out listlessly. What is it by listlessly, you know? Listlessly, as if without life. Means as they were hungry, they were not eaten anything, so they were looking listlessly. Okay, listlessly at the black street under the archway of the bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. We must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. No place to sit, no eating, nothing, so poor condition. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off. Take all the things, gold, and give all the things to them. Leaf by leaf. What is meant by leaf by leaf? Leaf by leaf, after leaf means part by part. Whatever, wherever the golds are there, you take out all the part by part and give away. Leaf after leaf, and the fine gold the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. Taken out all the gold from his, now his happy prince is looking very dull. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier, and they laughed and played in the street as they got gold. They were very happy. We have bread now, they cried. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. Everywhere it was so cold, okay? The street looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs. Furs means sweaters and the warm clothes, furs. And the little boys wear scarlet. Scarlet. What do you mean by scarlet, you know? Scarlet means bright red. Scarlet. Scarlet caps and skate on the eyes. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder, but he would not leave the prince. He loved him too well. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm and flapping his wings. It was so cold, so he tried to flap his wings to keep itself warm. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. He was not having that much strength also, but he tried to go and sit on his shoulder. Okay. Shoulder once more. Goodbye, dear prince, he murmured. He whispered near his ear. Will you let me kiss your hands? He said that. Let me kiss your hands. I am glad that you are going to Egypt at last. It's a little swallow. Prince thought that he is going to Egypt only. So he said, okay, I am very glad to hear this, said the prince. You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on the lips, for I love you. Don't kiss my hand because I love you. You can kiss my lips. It is not to Egypt that I am going, said the swallow. I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep. He is not? Is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down laid at his feet. At the moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue as if something had broken. As the swallow did, it also broke into pieces, okay? Into two pieces. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right in two. It also, that statue also broken into two from the middle. It certainly was a dreadful hard frost. It was so cold, and because of that, they broken and the swallow died. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town councillors. As they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. Dear me, oh, what happened? How shabby the prince looks, he said. How shabby indeed, cried the town councillors as well, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. The ruby has fallen out of his sword. His eyes are gone, and he is golden no longer, said the mayor. In fact, he is little better than a beggar. He is looking like as if beggar. Little bit good, but as if it is looking like the statue is looking like a beggar. Little bigger than a beggar, said the town councillor. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet, continued the mayor. We must really issue a proclamation. Proclamation is, what is that proclamation? Government order. That what, which proclamation? We must really issue a proclamation that birds are not to be allowed to die here. And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So they pulled down the statue of Happy Prince. As he is no longer beautiful, he is no longer useful, said the art professor at the university. So they have called that studied personality, and they said, now it is not good, so we will pull it out. Then they melted the statue in furnace. What a strange thing, said the overseer, means those who were seeing. Of the workman at a foundry. This broken leg heart will not melt in furnace. That heart is not melting in the furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it on the dust heap where the dead swallow was also lying. Bring me two most precious things in the city, said God. God said, get me two precious things from the city. He ordered one of his angels. So angel brought him the laden heart and the dead bird. So this two heart, laden heart, the heart of statue of Happy Prince and the bird. You have rightly chosen, said God, for you in my garden of paradise, this little bird shall sing forever more, and in my city of gold, the prince shall praise me. So these two personalities are there in the paradise with our God. So here we have seen that, what was the theme? In the earlier lecture we have seen that the lecture, the outer part is not precious. Your inner heart is very precious. How kind you are you? How generous are you? How you are giving, lending your helping hand to others. These things are very important. So this is a very beautiful story, and take one type of, you know, we get one type of inspiration from this story written by Oscar Wilde. Read this lesson once again. I hope, dear children, you might have understood this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.